I'm Anthony Bueno. I'm the director and producer and writer of Cleaning Up the Town, Remembering Ghoustbusters, a retrospective journey into how the classic Ghoustbusters film is made. It all started about 12 years ago when we were doing a documentary about American wealth in London. And Ghoustbusters is just my favourite film, and there's no other kind of like part of it. It was the right time in my childhood, and I just loved it. So because we were interviewing John Landis, just like, well, I might ask him and see if we can get Dan Aykroyd for an interview. And that was kind of, and we all ended up having lunch, as you do. And he just, I said, okay, chance of getting Dan Aykroyd. He said, yeah, sure, I could get you, Danny. And then that was it. So me and my sister, Claire, who also produced it, just chiseled out kind of like the structure of how we were going to do it, and then sent out invites and to see if anyone bit, and they did, thankfully. So, and then 12 years later, here we are. The one bit that always sticks out in my mind is when we interviewed Richard Edlund and Terry Rindell, who was part of Boss Film, and how Boss Film was set up during the kind of the making of Ghoustbusters. But it was like the amount of knowledge that they had to kind of, whereas these days it's all essentially computers, and I'm not putting anything down, but you know, you play around in Photoshop or in After Effects and you create something, whereas they needed to actually understand how to build a printer to create the effects they need and design film stocks that they would send those specifications to Kodak for them to send that film stock back. So, I remember at that point, it just kind of blew my mind, because it was just like, I didn't even know it was, you just don't think about things like that. You know, most things are off the shelf these days, but they have to construct everything. So for me, it was that kind of discovery. And then the more people you talk to, the more you find out all those little kind of stories and the dynamics and how different people kind of like were and how they were with each other and worked with each other. And that was like, there was always the thing that stuck out in my mind from like the early days. Just like, okay, there's a lot more to kind of this film that I didn't know about. Probably others did, more than likely. But it was just, that was the fun part for me. And then you sit down, you learn about these things and learn how things happen in Return of the Jedi. And it's just like, we'll save that for another film, you know.
I've had a chance to sit down with so many of the principal cast members. I'm curious if there was a particular anecdote that they shared, a particular memory from set that you were the most blown away by, that as a fan had the biggest impact on you.
Bill Murray could be a bit awkward. That wasn't necessarily as a surprise. That's a really good question. There was quite a few of them. I mean, Annie Potts, I don't know if it's in this version. There'll be a longer version that comes out on VOD and stuff. And there's a story that Annie Potts tells about the first day she worked with Bill Murray, and even though she knew him. And that was like one of the more entertaining and probably more honest sort of like portrayal. Because most people, you know, they tell you how things are, but they keep it polite. But I remember Annie Potts being particularly straightforward about how working Bill Murray was actually like. And Harold as well. Harold was extremely in-depth about how the genesis of all that kind of like worked when he first kind of heard about the film and sat with Dan Aykroyd and grew from there. So it was everybody had something that was like a particular gem. The hardest part was finding those bits to put in the doc, because even though some stories are fantastic, if they don't fit the narrative, then you can't kind of put it in. It just feels like you've shoehorned it in. So that was the hardest part for me, kind of like within the edit. But everyone had something there. But Annie Potts' story about Bill Murray turning up late is one worth waiting for.
What are you most hoping that both diehard fans of Ghoustbusters and people who are just discovering the franchise take away from this film, from this documentary?
I hope it's like, they just to kind of take away what it was like to work on that film. That, you know, you can see like the energy from everybody and that kind of, you know, the enjoyment they all had on the varying levels, whether it was the people in front of the camera or the people behind the camera. And you get to see the personalities of the people that made the film, which was important for us from the very beginning. And they're going to read stuff that they already knew about, but hopefully in a slightly different way or a different context than what they'd already heard it. And hopefully they might find some things that are different that they've never heard of before. So, but I think my main thing was always about, these are the people, these are the personalities. That's why we interviewed so many people for the film. And that's what kind of goes into making a film and making a successful film. It's when all of a sudden you get that kind of like, that liquid gold, when everyone kind of like can get in the room at the same time and come out with ideas. That was quite rewarding. And that's what I'm really hoping people are going to take away from this.
Cleaning Up the Town, Remembering Ghoustbusters. It is the definitive documentary about the making of Ghoustbusters. And we've been able to secure over 45 interviews for speaking in people in front of the camera and behind the camera to tell the story of and give their recollections of how Ghoustbusters was made and recall that from 1984. the thing about Ghostbusters is that you've got all the elements that humans can connect to. There's a story that makes you scared with the paranormal. You've got a love story. You've got humour. You've got people setting up and going into business for themselves. So there's all elements that people can relate to. So, you know, it's very kind of grounded amongst all the fantastical special effects and visual effects that entertain, really.
One of the reasons that Ghostbusters remains for everyone a landmark is because of the breakthrough visual effects work that was done on that film. Can you talk about, for you, what the most fascinating part of that reveal has been from kicking over the archives of that process?
Well, I think what was transparent was the ingenuity. You know, these guys were actually building cameras to be able to process, you know, they were speaking to the Kodak about film stock, and they were actually generating it and making it. So it wasn't that they bought stuff off the shelf. They were like, this is the effect that we need, and this is what we need to do it, and then building the machinery to do it. And I think that kind of innovation really is what sets it apart from anything else, really. Also the kind of the camaraderie. I mean, working for Richard Edlund and Boss Film, there's this real kind of team spirit and everybody working as a collective to because they cared about doing an amazing job.
There's obviously an amazing chemistry between the core cast members. Can you talk about how that was revealed in the amazing access that you had, sitting down talking with people like Harold and Dan about their memories of that period of their careers?
Well, what's interesting is that they all came from Saturday Night Live. So between the three, you know, lead Ghostbusters, they had that chemistry. They'd worked together for a long period of time. And then you've got the other actors, Sigourney Weaver, Ernie Hudson, David Margolese, and they all come from a theatre background. So they're the ones that bring the groundedness and that kind of no-nonsense. They're not the funny people, they're the straight people. And I think what that kind of allowed was the fusion of these two different types of discipline of acting to work well together. I think the hardcore fans will be satisfied to have things clarified that they might have thought had happened, and then so they'll have that clarified. Then they take it, then we take it kind of to the next level, and they learn even more. I think for new people coming to the franchise, they will understand and learn more that it isn't about digital effects. These guys, it was all practical, and I think. What's really, really important is that this film is a human interest story. You know, it tells about it, you see the personalities of people, so it isn't just about hardcore facts, which we provide, but the people talking about them provide a lot of humour and humanity, and it's actually a very funny film. I think people will be entertained.